like linear regression, logistic regression, cost function, optimization, model development, model building, model evaluation, regularization, overfitting, and introduction to neural network, and data pre-processing, visualization, data exploratory. So these are all the topics we covered in phase one. And in phase two, we have covered complete machine learning algorithms like decision tree classification, random forest, bootstrapping, bagging, boosting, SVM, PCA, KNN classifier, SNE, XGBM, LGBM, associate rule mining, hierarchical clustering. And followed by phase three, we have covered all the techniques like modeling, time series analysis, forecasting, data storage, web scraping, EDA for text processing, feature extraction, recommendation system, etc. So this is our final phase, and we have an agenda to cover introduction to deep learning, ANN, CNN, optimization of deep learning, YOLO, human activity recognition, compression of deep learning model using heuristic approach, RNN, GANs, LSTM, and AL model deployment. So we have a team of eminent academics and industry persons possessing in-depth knowledge in the area of machine learning with data science. So this STTP consists of series of lectures and an on-site practical session. And today we have our favorite Lakshmi ma'am with us. She's traveling with us right from phase one. And to give a short introduction about Lakshmi ma'am, she's currently designated as an educational research officer at Vishnu Educational Development and Innovation Center, run by Sri Vishnu Education Society, Hyderabad. She has been working in this educational sector since 1998. Our key focus is on exploring the dynamics of learning, dynamic of learner, and classroom dynamics. And she has been actively involved in educational research, and her research papers has been published both in international conference and in peer-reviewed journal. Her responsibilities at Vedic include conducting workshop, quality improvement education programs, e-learning initiatives, and integrated of technology and researching in the educational trends. And she has been completed a doctorate degree from Anna University in May 2017 under the supervision of Dr. Rajiv Sugumaran, IIT Madras. She got 22 years of teaching experience, and she has addressed innumerable guest lectures conducted by various, organized by various colleges, and she has covered approximately 15,000 to 20,000 faculty members she have been addressed through BIM platforms, Web, AACT, DST workshop. She has been invited as a jury of national level conference and student symposium. She has been invited as a keynote speaker as well. She has one patent in her name. She has a vast experience attending more than 100 workshops, conference, and she has completed more than 800 certifications in the workshops and programs, both online and offline. And she has built a software model based a biophysiological potential on cognitive feature. This software is known as KYC, that is Know Your Caliber. So our area of expertise includes data structure, theory of computation, data analytics, machine learning, deep learning, and big data analytics. It's very happy to have Lakshmi ma'am with us. My hearty welcome to all the participants, faculties from various universities, colleges, industry person, research scholars. I welcome you all to this phase four STTP. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your introduction and inaugural note. Yeah, welcome you all to the STTP 4 session. I'm so happy to meet you again, once again, in this platform. I would like to ask a simple survey question. How many of you intermediate level deep learning, any one of you are there? You can give me yes in the text window. Expertise with deep learning. I would like to know. I'm just looking into the chat window. Yes, okay. One member, beginner. Yeah, fine. One S, beginner. In anyone, either familiarity with some model or few models, that's fine. I would like to know, because what level I wanted to move further, not for today. At least I am invited for another two more sessions, so I can think what way I can contribute. That is the reason I'm questioning this. Yeah, beginner. Yeah. beginner in the sense I mean to assume that you know something in deep learning. That is what, little bit, I'm not asking too much, little bit if you are experienced, those only I request you to give you a comment in the chat window. So around maybe a dozen of members familiar with, that's fine. Yeah, that's fine. So somehow you all exposed towards a neural network, that much I can assume. So with that we can go ahead. Yeah, thank you all. This gives me fair idea. So let us go for laying foundation today. I'll be giving the holistic picture of how the deep learning works and what are all the models, applications, use cases, something, a kind of motivation I'm going to bring in, and terminologies, familiarity I'm bringing, bit mathematics I am bringing. So these are all the way I am addressing today. Nothing more you can expect today. So today, the day one we are starting, assuming that only 12 to 13 members are introduced to deep learning, others may be yet to dive into deep learning. That is the reason I wanted to lay foundation today and familiarity with the terminologies and holistic picture, types of models and applications. These are all those things we are going to discuss and some directions. And I'll be giving foundations to the TensorFlow. TensorFlow is one of the famous package. The moment we step into practical session, without the support of language or libraries or packages, we may not able to complete our research activity or whatever, our business applications we cannot do. So for that, I'll be introducing TensorFlow. This is what today's agenda. First half an hour, it will look like a story, a necessary motivation, the kind of curiosity I wanted to create. Yeah, these are all those things available under the artificial intelligence or deep learning. So that kind of curiosity. So with that familiarity, you can choose any one of the vertical domain. Unless otherwise we touch upon vertical domain, research will not flourish. Even we cannot become business consultant. All the generic level of understanding would be helpful for teaching. If you are into teaching and training development, then breadth is required, because you may need to empower students or faculty or anyone, any being you need to empower. By the time you should have the breadth of this domain. When you want to become a researcher, or when you want to be a consultant for industry, or you want to develop applications by your own way. And recently for software industry, no need of any other stuff to be invested. The moment we are familiar at something, we can open a website, we can open an article, we can start writing a blogs or anything. So through that, we can create awareness with the GitHub notebook, Kaggle notebook. We can showcase what are all our expertise and where and all, what are all the product or projects we have done for the learning point of view or for the consulting point of view. All those things we need to showcase and exhibit. That exhibition is sufficient to share in all the social media like Instagram and WhatsApp through your known circles and LinkedIn and Facebook, and you can create even YouTube channel. These are all sufficient enough to attract your businesses. You can become a freelancer. Whatever you are doing, you can be into that role. In addition, you can take up these all the roles. So this is how you can move without any investment. In the large scale, you can even hire, you can build a team, and you can run your own firm. For that also, a little bit of expertise or subject knowledge is necessary for hiring even the right people. So with that note, assuming that almost I can see I gone through the participants list in the, what is it, participants column of Zoom. I could see minimum 60% of the name familiar to me somehow through my cues, not by remembering. So from the HTTP 2.3, 1 and 2 itself, a lot of changes happen. But the most 60% of the participants consistently participating in the 2, 3 and 4. So this 1 month expertise is more than enough to build your next level of career. So with that note, let me start deep learning timeline. So this also I addressed in the STDP 1. It is not a new Mekkallu started the first model in 1943. Before that dark era until 1943, first white paper on Mekkallu he presented in the conference in 1943. Those days itself, neural net has been addressed. Subsequently, you can see how it is growing, and 2014 GAN has come. And now people are working on model compression, explainable AI, so many other avenues. We will look at one by one. It's going on, it's expanding. Then they are trying to build a deep neural learning network suitable to the domain applications, like medical applications, drug discovery, or medical image processing, or robotic assistance for the surgery. Nowadays, robotic surgery much better than laparoscopy surgery. The invasion will become very lesser, and the cure of after post surgical recovery would become much more better. So, because even that MM is a matter, it will not damage other than the affected portion. MM control is also, millimeter control is also possible. When the human does, there would be a slight increase in damage unnecessarily happens. So that level it reaches. So customizing the model suitable to the domain itself, people are exploring right now. It is going in the advanced stage right now. But however, the initial breakthrough thought happened in the 1943. Now, why it is becoming popular? Why we are talking about deep learning AI, it is inevitable. In the near future, AI is the mantra going to revolve around all the disciplines, including commerce department, economics, and what not, engineering. I'm not touching upon engineering. Engineering is inevitable. So Industry 4.0 is completely towards automation. The moment we talk about automation, artificial intelligence only going to play a role, inclusive of reinforcement technique. Actually, in this entire 1 month workshop, none of the resource person touched upon reinforcement techniques. That may be differently we need to address, different session we need to address. It is completely far away from the supervised and unsupervised learning. So that would become different. But whenever we are going for automation, reinforcement learning is also essential, not only the supervised and unsupervised learning. Let us walk through why it is becoming famous with the step by step and what is the timeline. These are all the stuff we are discussing. Now let us move on to the difference between traditional program, machine learning program. Already we addressed, however, data and program both fed to machine. So then together it will work and it will produce output. Whereas when we come to machine, data and output, these two, that means we are giving that response variable value. We are feeding output and data, including program also. It will come out with the rule, the learning parameters. That is what the difference between traditional and machine learning. So the holistic picture is artificial intelligence. Then machine learning is a subset. And deep learning is a part of machine learning only, can be said. But the moment we bring neural network, the word or the concept or mathematics behind of neural network is brought into the programming, immediately it is termed as exclusive word deep learning. That is the only difference. More or less, it will be the same. Coming to this, what exactly difference? It works well for small data. It works on only the larger data set. Data set must be larger. Deep learning is greedy of data. Greedy of data, that word itself, you can imagine how much data it eats up. So it will eat lot and lot of data for training phase. So dependent on low end machine, this is dependent on high end machine, starting from GPU and it goes to TPU. So that level, whenever it comes for the social media analytics, larger data analytics, definitely TPU is required. GPU will not fit enough. Maybe for academic projects, GPU is sufficient. Divide the task into subtasks, solve them individually, and finally combines the result. Solves the problem end to end. So deep learning. These are all the little bit difference. The moment data is lesser, training time will also be lesser. Here, data is larger, training time would be larger. Testing time may increase. Here, less time to test the data. So that is a little bit difference here. Testing phase, it will be more, and here it will be less. So anything, the problem which we touch upon, machine learning or deep learning, First, we need to understand the problem statement. That problem statement understanding is essential. So with that only it is possible to address. For example, just in the morning before, just to warm up myself, I was reading one article. In USA, 40 to 50% of divorce is filed every year, recent days, since recent years. So one of the university professors together, they were attached with the counselors. So from the counselors, the data they are collecting, around 11,000 couples information. Normally, whenever we go for family court or family counselor or individual this family counseling sector, if you go, they will work on one-on-one, case to case, reveal anything else. They may be successful counselor, they may not be successful counselor. So they will be giving counseling for the female and the male. So that pair may be successful, but they will be earning money. They will have some statistics of counseling, some knack and tricks they may follow, and they will be using some kind of magical words or magical procedures. Somehow they will be successful. So because of that success, only people are approaching them. So if not 100%, they would be successful with the 70. But what is happening? The knowledge is with them only. The way they are counseling, how the success is happening is with them. Now, what these professors are doing is those data, that 11,000 couples data they have collected. So what are all the data? Even I don't know. That article that didn't give any other core detail. So how that model or application is useful? They completely use the artificial intelligence. Through that, they are generalizing. Any couple, the newly married couple, they can approach this model. It will tell the successful family relationship, the deep satisfaction with each one another, each one of them, how much it would be, what is the success rate of their family life. This is a prediction. So this is how research going. They are telling further, there is a scope to refine and improve this model. This is how we need to look at what are all the things happening around us. That problem we need to understand first. So for that problem, we need to translate it into the scientific representation. So when these guys are doing, they may be using some psychological approach, they may be using some behavioral approach, whatever, but may not be scientific. So this complete the human counseling matter, they are bringing into in terms of automation, so scientifically predicting something. So this never-ending problem can be fine-tuned, but it is a good attempt. So this is what I can say, I can say it is a kind of innovation. It is not breakthrough, innovation. So they are trying. So what I can say, later part, if any one of us undergo a training with that existing counselors, along with this model, definitely we would be the much more better counselor than themselves. Combining these two entities. So this is how we need to think around what it is happening and how we can. Then we need to appropriately choose the model. It could be a machine learning model or deep learning model. Then we need to prepare the data completely. We need to transform all other things. By this time, you may be very versatile. Pre-processing, they used to call. Then cleaning the data, they used to call. Then transforming the data, they used to call. Then they will be naming within that transformation, they will be calling feature selection, and within that they will be telling feature engineering, and coming to that data transformation techniques, other different data transformation technique. The moment these all are necessary underlying assumption, the moment we choose one model, there are model, they will be putting lot of conditions or assumptions, necessary requirements. That is called parametric learning, parameter learning or parametric learning. The example, classic example for parametric learning is linear regression. It is a very, very tricky model. Whenever we touch upon linear regression, it will take a lot of time for the discussion. So this linear model, one such pre-assumption is, it should not have multicollinearity, minimum. This is one. It has a lot of other assumptions, necessary assumption, and data should be normally distributed. So these are all the two assumptions we need to primarily consider. for the linear regression. Only then we can build a reliable model. You may be having better accuracy, that is not the matter. Always we should understand the moment we build the model, what is the reliability of the model. For that, we need to understand a lot of stuff. First, we need to start understanding how the model works. How can I build model for my data or my own research problem or domain? That is what our need should be. Subsequently, we need to go to the higher pedestal. How to validate the model? How much reliable my model is? How much my model is best enough? How my answer is going to be helpful for the business domain in the reality without any other side effects? So these are all would be the next level. So step by step we can go. Then we can go for advancement. Then we can think of breakthrough, bringing breakthrough in the domain of artificial intelligence. Say vector to counter, natural language processing, counter vectorizer we used to see. Now the moment this text is passed on, it will produce the numerical value, counting, vector counterizer, some word is there. So this is the breakthrough for the entire NLP. Till then, it is a little bit tough. After that only Siri, Apple Siri, Google Alexa, so many things have come. Now, till then it was very tough. So this is one of the breakthrough in the natural language processing that we can reach after certain number of years. So next we need to choose the model suitability to the prediction, what we are expecting, what is the kind of output we are wanting from the data. Accordingly, we need to choose the model. Then train the algorithm, test the algorithm. The difficult phase is these two. Then training time also, there are other difficulty challenges would be there. Hyperparameter tuning, model validation, reliability check. Reliability check is advanced level. Hyperparameter tuning is also bit advanced level. So these are all the two stuff we need to further devise this algorithm. So with that note, let us move on. Why deep learning? The amount of data, this is the tricky question. We need to understand this mantra. Amount of data becomes more, the performance would become deteriorated going down. Look at the graph, only two lines. It is easy to understand, nothing more to draw. So this declines, it both together raises for certain amount of data. Once it reaches that threshold level of or quantity of data, it starts deteriorating. It's coming down. The performance is coming down. Whereas the performance is stable with the deep learning. This is the reason we are choosing deep learning, that we must understand. Scientifically, people proved it. So this graph is the answer for why deep learning and when deep learning. Now, why deep learning is ready? Now I am going to answer for when deep learning we need to use. Why deep learning is, the amount of data becomes larger. What is the threshold value? I don't know. That threshold I'm not talking about. Then it will go down. The performance is not appreciable. Whereas deep learning performance would become appreciating one. That's all. Big data. Only for the big data context, deep learning is coming to the picture. When you can say big data, normally 3 V's they used to say. The recent update, as on today, there are 7 V's. Now, no more of 3 V's or 4 V's for big data, 7 V's for big data have come. Volume, you all know. WhatsApp information, just imagine WhatsApp, every one of us keep on typing. The moment the morning I wake up, 30 plus messages would be there. So, good morning message, good night message, useless, useful, whatever you imagine, forward message, volume. How much people are generating the volume. Variety. We do generate a lot of variety. PDF we are attaching, Word file we are attaching. Nowadays we are IPYNB notebook also we are sending through the WhatsApp. What not you can imagine, video, audio, and music, images, photography, and lot many things we are telling. Velocity. Per minute, how much data comes? Velocity we cannot measure. Just imagine WhatsApp alone is sufficient. Then if you wish, you can extend your imagination towards LinkedIn, Twitter, Gmail, YouTube, whatnot. After lockdown, the number of videos uploaded per second, per minute, tremendous, 5x time towards YouTube. after this lockdown. Next, variability. Just imagine all the AICTE adult workshops earlier, it would have been a conventional model. Nowadays, everybody is into online. Even now, SRM is telecasting on YouTube. So that is what the velocity, veracity, variability, visualization, value. So these are all the, these associated with the big data. Now, when we need to use the big data, deep learning, during the big data situation. That's all. That is the answer. See, what is the need of AI? 7.7 global population, 5.1 billion unique mobile user, 4.3 billion have access to internet, 3.4 billion have active social media presence, 94% of them accessing it over mobile phones. So the data is flooded around us. So that it is essential. Then how they can use it? They are making money out of it. They are not working as a social service for our chatting and everything. No matter, any moment, anyone they will identify. Within 48 hours, the entire history they can collect about us. Within 48 hours, if not, assume 1 week is sufficient. The name X is given. Immediately they will get connected and they can able to get the data from the day one of our social media posting to till date, what are all our watch data, what are all the way we have communicated, what post we have articulated, to whom we have contacted, when we have contacted, on what context we have contacted. Until the need arises, they don't touch upon. They may be watching only few social security issues and alerts, code words. So every time they will be having algorithm related to especially social attacks. These are all those things, terroristic attack. These are all those things to monitor. Even the moment I start talking over YouTube, Zoom, I don't know. That is depending upon the private privacy policy. The moment I'm addressing on the YouTube, it will be noted. My audio signal will be noted on what context I'm talking. What is the way I am, what is the previous sentences and the next sentences I'm using? Is there any coding, decoding is happening? So a lot of things they will be analyzing. Every one of us is monitored, including mobile calls, including our WhatsApp. Every data is monitored, but not to your personal level, social alert level. The same, they can use the person X identity is given within a week. They will collect the entire information. That is what is going on. Now coming to this, these are all $1 billion making business, not $1 million, $1 billion making business. Google, Facebook, WhatsApp, look at. So this is within 1 minute, I mean to say, these are all before lockdown. After lockdown, you and me cannot predict what's happening. They are not a social servicer. They do earn billions and billions of money through this WhatsApp, through this Facebook, through this Google. So although these three seems to be free, these four seems to be free, even this Instagram seems to be free, they do lot of revenue making. They even if not they are doing revenue making, with that data they will be doing lot of breakthrough researches. So that will fetch the top performer. You look at Google and Amazon, what technology they don't have, what they want. They are the legendary of all the breakthrough of the technicality of computer science. So that level they will be rocking. Somehow they will make use of money with our data, with our all our useless information or useful information, whatever. They know how to work. So they will bring model. And how this is happening? Next question. Big data time, we need to use deep learning. Fine. How this big data has come into the picture? Why it has come into the picture? Moore's law. All of us would have studied digital electronics at least, or physics. Moore is a salutable person for the entire hardware growth, right from EDWAC, ENIAC, one human machine. Imagine one human machine is equal to one bigger institution those days. Nowadays, a palm carrying laptop, quantum computing started into the coming into the picture. It is in the market. So the palm computer is available. So how that is possible? That is because of the hardware revolution. So hard drive cost per gigabyte reduces. See, look at the cost of gigabyte with very cheaper, what was the cost? With a higher capacity, what is the cost? It reducing. Frankly to speak, the when I studied my BA, the machine which I used, beats out we used to get, just clicking that keyboard unwantedly we used to do. We used to feel amazing. See, music is coming out of this computer like that. We used to make fun. But nowadays, artificial intelligence creates music, auto-generated music. You no need to learn Sarigama Padanasa. Automatically you can bring a composition with your program. It is much more beautiful than A.R. Rahman music. A.R. Rahman himself working with AI, with one of the university professors we have connected. He is working with AI for the music industry because he cannot survive with his own brain no more. The days are changing. So the technical guy starts becoming this musical generation, then what would be his own industry? He need to be up to date. Although he has good knowledge in music and he is a famous director, he can't sit idle. He should be much more alert than us. So to retain, in order to retain his fame and name. So he is working with the professors closely towards artificial intelligence. So that level we reached because of this hard work. Next, coming to this all, how this deep learning is possible? This is possible with Python. The famous, the polling conducted by KD Nuggets. So through that poll, industry poll, they have identified Python is the first or primary language used for deep learning. Secondary is RapidMiner, third is R, next is Excel. Then Anaconda, this is what, this all maybe the year 2019, that is what. See, but although 17, 18, 19, Python retains to be the top, I'm not sure. Industry report says the future is of Julia. If you want to be popular after 2-3 years or after 1 year or 2 year, you need to learn Julia. And you need to be expertise in and out of this, both machine learning and deep learning. This is meant for my high-end computation, even for website, full stack architecture. So in future, any website comes, the hit goes, scalability is massive. Imagine YouTube, at present, only in India, minimum 1 lakh videos would be streaming, uploaded in this moment I'm telling. So that scalability level, how we need to do full stack website, stable website, machine learning and deep learning. These three all together are any one of the stuff. If you become master with Julia, then you can earn packet full of money. So starting from day one today, first this end you can become familiar, nothing wrong. Maybe after 1 year you can touch upon this Julia. Then immediately you will be the rocking performer in the industry, training and development or industry side, whatever you want, you can choose. Data is giving rise to a new economy. That is the reason people are fond of this machine learning and deep learning. Look at Instagram, value for deal, photo sharing. The role of Instagram is for photo sharing. Then WhatsApp. Now this WhatsApp, Instagram is owned by Facebook. Alphabet. So every company is working on particular domain. See, healthcare, Intel is working on self-driving car, Microsoft is working for business networking, then keyboard and artificial intelligence, Oracle is working for cloud platform marketing. So everywhere, everyone, they work for data, but the way they work for data would become different. Their business model would become different. Now, just I'll read, nothing to worry, I'll show demonstration for each and every application. Speech analytics, video analytics, image processing, image captioning, image recognition. Maybe Monday morning I'll be addressing this one, image recognition, person. It will recognize the face and it will tell person. That is YOLO. And one more topic I'll be addressing, automatic activity recognition. What I'm doing, I'm speaking. preparing pizza, like that activity recognition I'll be doing. Space research, chatbot, climate analysis, article writing, fake image. Till today, we are failed to understand the climatic condition. A week ago or 15 days ago, north Jammu and Kashmir, that side 3.5 Richter tremor was identified. People became frightened, but there is no damage. 1 week ago, very bad way, 8.5 Richter, Turkey, affected by earthquake. Just 4 days ago, Sri Lanka near, all the big fish and dolphins and all whales, these are back. They are not able to walk on. Human could not push those. So it is starving for food and all other survival conditions. These are all the indications something going wrong. Animal could predict much better than human. But we the human failed to predict what will happen for us. So that is another challenging problem. This is one of the company during race 2020. I'm not sure which company, IBM or I don't know, TCS, one of the company abroad located, one of the firm is working on earthquake prediction and climatic analysis using artificial intelligence. Article writing, these days article writing is possible through bots. Given the topic and the context, it will write article on behalf of you. So it is possible. It is already existing. I'll show one of that. You for English paraphrasing and what to say, you will have grammar proofreading. For that, you can use, I can't assure for perfection, SpinBot. What is this? This much big. 1 minute. SpinBot is available. QuillBot is available. Ref and write. You can note down those who are all researchers. This all will be useful for you for grammar checking and paraphrasing. And one more is, what is this? Reverse spell checker. Among these, all the best spell checker is what I am using, Google Doc. Google Doc is much more powerful for spelling check and paraphrasing. That putting comma, automatically it will suggest. Whenever we are writing, no, it is very tedious for most of us to appropriately to write paraphrasing and this all. So you can note it. I am listing that all. So these all the tools will be useful for plagiarism control and what else it will be useful? Paraphrase. So you ref and write. It will have some website. You just go through, because I will go out of scope if I start telling. These all into different contexts. So that is where this article writing comes to the picture. These are all the tools uses artificial intelligence for this. Fake image, fake news detection. So in the lockdown, no, they will take one of the famous personality, they will put cotton in the nose and RIP they will put. You would have noticed. So people will be doing a lot of memes and unnecessary fake news. So people are working on it. This is a hot topic today. Fake image and fake news reduction. This is want of the hour also. RNN generated speech based on context and personality. This is also succeeded. How I am telling for writing, when writing is possible, why not speech? So it will start talking in Obama's voice. It is available right now on the internet. You know, Obama, famous personality, Obama, his voice, his personality, they have trained. So it is available. How he would be addressing. He used to greet, no, that citizens of America like that, no, that all together, they trained all Obama of speech. Then it starts generating newly called Obama speech. Then internet, next is deep colorization, black and white to color image. Microsoft Word itself, it has. I have seen this maybe 8 years ago. Those days itself, Microsoft Word would have brought. We can put image, any color it is possible. My face, it can put it in violet, green color, any color is possible. Internet and the cloud is biology. Nowadays, people are working for it, medicine and biology. People are telling, in future, dogs are barking to each other. No, we don't know what is what for it is speaking. We say that it is barking. but we cannot understand in what field it is barking, either at a human or to dog to dog. Future, it is possible to predict the feeling of animal's emotion and what context it is speaking, they are trying to tell. It is possible, it seems. Then another hardcore area going is genome. Genome is genetic analysis. Individualized medicine, personalized learning, we are telling us as academician. Personalized medicine is the hardcore area. Now, what is the trendy research in the healthcare is personalized medicine. Every body constitution is different. Although you and me look like same, your body constitution is different. My body constitution is different. So depending upon the body constitution, the medicine is going to be provided. That is where the research is going on. So genomic analysis or genetic analysis, whatever you can, then drug discovery. So all together, this personalized medicine, drug discovery together, it is possible in the near future with the support of AI and the genome analysis. So this is what they are predicting, life expectancy of the person. That means years of living in near future, maybe 5 years or after 10 years, it would double, it seems, because they can understand perfectly how the cell functioning is happening, what is chemical dynamics happening between cells, and the chemical dynamics between the fluid which we drink and the cell, what is happening? Every dynamics, fluid dynamics also people are bringing into artificial intelligence. So through that fluid dynamics, that is a mathematical core, and artificial intelligence, together people can able to understand what's happening inside of my cell, inside of my body, inside of my affected organ. Nowadays, no, the doctor says some medicine, I am eating, whether that medicine is bringing side effect or good effect or no effect also, I am eating. Then doctor will understand my position maybe after a month, by the time the disease would be aggravated. But through this artificial intelligence and the breakthrough personalized medicine, they can monitor the moment I swallow the medicine, what's happening. Maybe within 3 trials, they can conclude whether my medicine goes in my body positively, negatively or neutral. Immediately, they can change. At least that much level of prediction is possible, if not the cure. Media and entertainment already uses security and defense, autonomous vehicle. Nowadays, two-wheeler also autonomous vehicle is research going on. Then language processing, Siri, Alexa, so many product have come. IBM also has their own sentiment analysis. This all already late detection and traffic sign. I would like to announce today, maybe near future, I cannot say month and year and all, I would be working on NLP for imitating the famous poets. Tamil Nadu, one of the famous poet, is Bharatiyar. So if we look at, it is a big loss for the human race, Bharatiyar. What is the human loss is Bharatiyar, let me not kill that person, okay? Bharatiyar, we lost him. Before even I born, he died. I don't know when he died, that and all. But the poems are powerful. We cannot give birth back to Bharati. So rather we can use artificial intelligence. If we look at that poem, it has a lot of texture, lot of structure, semantic, syntactic in it. So we need to go for all types of reasoning, inductive reasoning, deductive reasoning, abductive reasoning, transductive reasoning. There are 4 reasoning only available, and many more reasoning, logical syllogism. So these are all the reasoning types available mathematically. If we apply all the types of reasoning, we can build a bot. That bot is Bharatiyar bot. This bot can give poem now also in the style of Bharatiyar, although he is no more. It is possible. If any one of you are interested, you can join with me if you are ready to be part of this project. So this, it was fascinating to me, so I would like to take that project. Nowadays, see, this is possible. What is this possible? This, look at, there is a heart shape, sand. Even kids, if you put them in the seashore, no, they will be writing something on the sand. Or even lovers, they will write their lover name, their name on the sand in the seashore. It is like that only. But this is the tagline given by artificial intelligence. A cute little dog sitting in the heart drawn on a sandy beach. A dog walking next to a little dog on top of a beach. So this is the message given by artificial intelligence driven program for the uploaded photography. This much level people are reaching. Now, 24 sector, after learning deep learning, which sector you want to be expertise? So this is what 24 sectors you can touch upon. Education is also available. I tell you, my intuition says, based on my reading or whatever, within 48 months, I guarantee, yesterday Deloitte have brought an article. If you wish, I can share the Deloitte article. What he have written, that the company has written for the future of education, how it should become. People are wanted to bring lot of disruption into education. After 48 months, not even single day, the conventional teaching learning practices will happen. I don't know what will happen, what change is going to come, that I don't know how it is going to come. So we need to be alert for our own survival. We need to be ready. But one thing I can guarantee, anyone, whatever may be your expertise into education field, be into, then you can able to fit enough. So this is what transport department, banking and the personal finance, transport, lot of stuff is going on with AI. Whenever I book this omnibuses, it will tell exactly where I am standing. It will tell, this is the picking point for you. You should stand there. Then we need to be there. It will tell this many minutes away from here, this many kilometer away from you. We are nearing, watching like Ola, Uber, after entering, we can able to see, where the car is coming, which turn it is taking. Like that for bus also, it is available nowadays. So lot and lot of analytics they are doing, and they are tracking through each and every passenger, and things are happening. And even where the vehicle is traveling, we can able to identify. Even nowadays, most of the data in the control room, it is available. If it is possible, we can even apply. Our own spouse may travel alone. We can able to track the vehicle activity, in which area it is moving, how it is moving. Everything is possible. So policies, government, everything is changing. Events, insurance, cyber security, and MHRD, Electronics and the Ministry of Electronics and IT, they have taken the resolution, some lakhs together, maybe 4 to 10 lakhs people, they wanted to empower into AI in near 2 to 3 years in India, it seems. So the moment you become expertise in this all, you can become trainer also. Lot of opportunities are going to come up. So you just to look through whenever you are free, because just these are all, you can even expand the image size. I cannot zoom and show you. You can usages of artificial intelligence in 24 sector. I have put forth here. This is not general. This is the company giving offer or services to this 24 domains. They have brought the mind mapping way of marketing their own freelancing services. But imagine what else would be there. So this is how we need to understand the sector. Again, look at this Amazon guy. The title they have kept, Amazon is at war with everyone. I was fizzy. Then immediately I was looking at this, no war at all. What they mean to say, they captioned like that for attracting, dragging the attention of people. Audio related, Scribd, then Google Home, Amazon Alexa, then Spotify. These are all their competitor. The outer circle is competitor. The inner circle is Amazon product. That means they own everything that they indicate. The entire document I will share with you, don't worry. Not even single line I will miss, and I will give you what, whenever I come to the session, whatever I address, I will give you. Nothing is my own. I compiled from the Google, that's all. Or all other social media. Now let us look into enough theory. Now let us look into one by one. Just I'll create wow factor, nothing more. I'm not going to talk about technicality. After 10 minutes or 15 minutes, I will talk, come to technicality. This is one of the application. That link with the Word file itself, I'll give. So let's draw. What now? It will put you the condition. 1 minute. is going, I need to draw. If I draw, it will tell you circle. I see circle. Appa, audio is coming. It is telling, I see circle, moon, mountain, potato. So now next. So bigger audio is coming. Audio, it is coming. Audio, digitized audio. Next, if I draw, apple, ceiling fan, lobster, I see butterfly. After putting this dot, it is telling, I see butterfly. Lot of sound. Or snake, it is telling. It is telling all the possibility of my drawing. Digital is recognizing my drawing. These all you can give it to your kids for fun. Let them learn. Now, next, I'll go to, yeah, 1 minute, somebody. You are Bharatiyar University. Yeah, fine. I thought somebody is joining with my Bharatiyar project. Okay, next, teachable machine learning TensorFlow. Next, I will show. One by one, I'll create wow factor. One is over. You just work on it. You will look like a kid for half an hour. So next, teachable machine learning. Look at here. This is get started. It is showing a lot of demonstration. I'll show you. Teachable machine, I gone. Image project. First image project. Then post, I will come. Audio project later. So image project now. What I supposed to do? Web camera, it is already on. I need to on this web camera. After that, I'll show you one by one. 1 minute, I'll switch off this web camera. Yeah, I'm going to hold to record phone. With the phone, I'm telling, with the phone. With the phone, I'm using, with the headset, I'm training. Next, this is class 1, enough. Next, class 2. Without a headphone, I'm using phone, without headphone. So without headphone, enough. So now next to 2 class variable. So this 2 class variable, I have given the sample image. Now train model, it is training. So after this, I need to give you a posture. It will predict whether that belongs to class 1, class 2. Class 1 activity with the headphone, I was talking over phone. Class 2 without headphone, I was talking over phone. Next, either one posture I should give, then it will tell me appropriately what class it is. That's all. Minimum 15 images it should give. I had given more, it will do, sir. Yeah, I have come. Look at class 1. Although I didn't use mobile, it is giving the accuracy. Hope so you could be able to see all of you. 98. I'm going to bring a phone, then it is confused. Then I'm bringing out phone, then I'm without phone, class 2, headphone. See, totally I'm removing headphone, without headphone, how it is. So this is what, it will precisely predict the activity. Got it? Then now next to move on to the same post estimation. Similarly only, audio also, you try audio. Now pose estimation. For this also, pose, I need to give you a pose, some pose. You look at that, always pose estimation will be like this. Hold to record. Yeah, pose estimation. So I'm giving what the position it is telling. So this is called pose estimation. It will do. Next. What are all the position you are giving the training? This positions you need to give training. This post estimation, this is class 1. This same position only I'm trying to give. Nothing more I want to change now since it is trial session. Next webcam, class 2. Now post estimation. I somehow I need to click no. Next, this position I'm trying to give. So this post estimation, next it holds. So these are all coding available, internet. Even with the coding we can do. No need to use this ready-made. This is TensorFlow.js they have uploaded. So now training is happening. After training, we need to go for Kaggle, you are expecting me to explain. Okay, I will explain. Okay. Now, so next, see, this is the post estimation. Class two. It's telling something wrong. Class one, this position I did, class one, it has come right. Class two, see, what position I used, class one and class two. So this is how the model post estimation, it will work. Enough. Now audio, because audio, why I don't want to touch, no. I can't show you, I'm wearing the headphone. Next, let us go to the third. Only 5 to 6 I will show you. Rest all, I don't find time to show you. Later on, you can work on it. See, now, we need to use face. I need to draw, rest it will fill. Look at, face is there now. I'm going to draw eyes. What is this? It will try for, look at this trying, that black is my trial, that blue is machine trial. It is trying the human face, that's all. So next, one more I'll choose. I don't know what, it has something, butterfly, it has flower, lot of stuff it has, flower, mountain. If you choose mountain, it will automatically draw, see, it is teaching me, flower. If you have kids, you no need to teach. This digital itself will teach. Flower, sample it will teach. Say, I am holding here. See, leaf is putting automatically. I haven't put. So this is how this software helps. So enough. You can try this all object and get acquainted. That's fine. Now, like light tracking. Now, next move to next one. Eye tracking is, I don't know, my college, this I'm using. Next it is giving, 1 minute, I'll try. For drowsiness reduction, during riding, people will go drowsy, it will give alert for the passenger and or it will give audio, don't sleep, you are into drowsy, stop riding the car, that kind of thing. Several application, eye tracking, I'm using institution account, so it is not permitting me to open due to firewall. You can try, it will work. Next, face recognition with the bounding box. So it will recognize my face. So if you look at, I think I need to off this zoom camera. Zoom camera, it will not work. Yeah, this is bounding box. YOLO also the same, I'm going to show you Monday morning the coding. Bounding box, wherever I turn, face is recognized, bounding box. So any number of face also, not only single face, if any one of my friends joins beside me, it will put a bounding box. So this is face detection. It is possible through this, the metro train comes now, it will detect quickly the number of faces available. It will count because nobody should stand in few countries. They should give opportunity for everyone to sit because they are paying. They are citizen, they may file a case also. So it will give the alert, this many seats only available, this many members only should come. So that in a fraction of a second, it will detect the face detection. That is why that country are called a developed country. So developed country, one of the indication is 24 hours power supply with a cheaper cost. That level, if you reach only developed country, in all terms, this one of the, this one. Adding deep style, so many things are there, we don't find time to talk about to see this all. You can upload any photo. I'm going to upload one of my, favorite, my doggy photo I will upload. It will give the texture to that. I tried with my face, I can't show you demo with my face and all for you, na? So that this I'm going to show you. It takes for, what is the meaning is, it will change the texture. This is the input image. If we give this texture image, our uploaded image will go into that texture. For example, this is a texture my face will have. Like you can create a profile pictures like this for fun, avatar creation. Second Life is one of the platform. You please go through Second Life. It is AR, VR, people are talking now. 15 years ago, these guys are rocking. This is AR VR enabled platform, Second Life. Please go through without that. Second Life, Harvard University, lot of universities are offering course in the Second Life. So this is a platform, please go through. The moment you get in, you will get avatar. See, the pure white that dog was. It used to sleep with me sometimes, or not most of the time. So see, the texture is changed. This is not, it is pure white. The texture is changed. Now if I apply this one, the doggy style will become this. That's all. So just for fun, I don't know what application and all. This all done through artificial intelligence based. See, look at the texture is changed. This I have played. If I apply this one, you can notice much more better. That's all. So it has gallery of demonstrations. It would take minimum 2 hours to show everything. You just open and try. Sometime guidelines, they say, look at the doggy texture. New creature of the doggy. Nowhere this kind of doggy texture will be there. So that's all. These are all the applications. Next, anything. Wait a minute. One is very good. Lot of demo I have brought. Yay, good. This alone I was harvesting because of this workshop more than 6 hours. After more than 6 hours of search and analysis, these all gathered. Beyond that, so many. Wow, experiment with Google. I have put like that. Because then musical project. This I loved it, the musical project. Those who are all interested with music, you can listen. See, AI plus writing. Look at what one I did. Not this is video. Yeah. One minute. Teachable machine. See this one. Look at this one. Open source framework. See, after every filter, we will say no hidden layer, hidden layer. Hidden layer, this person image is input. It will do the feature extraction. Every layer in the hidden layer will collect some amount of feature in each and every layer. This is what happening internally. That black box system we used to call, no? That black box system hidden layer will have this kind of feature. So this is what the imagination visualization will happen. I'll be shortly talking about the technicality by that time. Oh my God, only 1 hour. Okay, let us move on. It's sufficient. You just go ahead. So all the, maybe more than this, you cannot able to gather a gallery, I guess. See, just no boring presentation, just have some AI demos. Look at this, this also. Whenever I written something additional that I wanted to show, but no time. So I request to spend some time. Nothing you are going to learn, just you learn, see to this all, create wow factor for your students. They will be coming behind of you, truly I tell you. After showing this all, people will be excited, your students, they will join you. You need to give some foundation, then they can take up any project which you give. Now let us get into the technical stuff. Deep learning, enough motivation, I guess. You may be tempted to take up artificial intelligence now onwards. Deep learning, otherwise called deep neural network. The moment we bring neural network with deeper, it is called deep learning. What is deeper is, I'll share definitely, don't worry. What is deeper is many layers. Layers are more and more, that is why it is called deeper neural learning network. Because of that only deep learning name has come. Why deep learning? Somebody asked question, you should tell this only. So it uses neural network for learning, and it uses a deeper layer, many layer, multiple layer, multi-layer architecture, so that it is called deep learning. That's all. Neural network, network of artificial neurons. Then what is neural network? People questions you. So you can able to understand network of artificial neurons. Building blocks of a neural network is artificial neuron. This is the mimic of human brain. People invented this neural network neuron architecture by the understanding of the brain. in our human body, the miraculous organ is brain. It is an organ, but intelligent organ. This is also organ. No intelligence for my hand. Neck is also organ. No intelligence for neck. But only the organ, the nature's creature, that is brain. So the brain mimic. So that part I don't want to touch upon. Building blocks of a neural network. Design any neural network. Let us see. Computer vision is one of the field with a neural network we can take up. Image and video, the moment you use, you can use computer vision, that is called predominantly used in neural network architecture is convolution neural network, CNN. This computer vision is useful for object detection, facial recognition, image classification. These are all image search. Pinterest, you just go to Pinterest, they will look at Google image is different. Pinterest is different. I will show, if time permits, the demo for Pinterest. A lot of awesome cards, mind map, concept map, infographic you will get. Fabulous. The Pinterest concentrates on aesthetic appearance, aesthetic sense of that card, than even the information. Information plus aesthetic. Both they will apply a condition. Pinterest, if you create a card, they will offer you money. How many circulation, how many share goes, no? You can earn money. You can be a part of Pinterest also. You can create video also. Video should become high quality, fabulous, aesthetic and informative. Only then they will accept your video. If not also, they will accept. But they won't ping your video. They won't promote your video. So Pinterest is a search engine or a gallery for image and video. I will share the material. I don't know why today everyone is asking for material. Every time I shared, maybe you are all newcomer, I think so. Soon after my session, immediate on the day, I used to dispatch to the coordinator. Nothing to worry. So be a part of Pinterest. Plenty of avenues for earning. Here also computer vision. Activity recognition, several variant, GANs. GANs also, one of the variant of CNN. The CNN is useful for these are all the research activities. It has several variant means, slightly they will modify. Fast CNN, so many CNN. If I talk about CNN, that would go for 3 hours. You have even the session this week. Then next, GRU. GANs, this is another variant. Natural language processing is another domain. This works on text and audio. Recurrent neural network is the architecture used. Chatbots, language translation, Alexa, Siri Home, summarization. So these are all the use of natural language processing. Summarization means what? See, there may be a famous YouTube channel. Maybe 1,000, maybe 10,000 comments people may be texting. Is it feasible for me to sit and study? So finally, this bot should harvest this all. Need to give the summary report to me. This is what, even anything. We may be having LinkedIn page. The famous companies, they have LinkedIn page. How many followers? What are all the comment has come? They will be doing through summarization of that replies. Several variant available. Natural language processing. Recurrent neural network is the base. Here, convolution neural network. The variants are GRU, LSTM. These are all famous. I want to do market study using Facebook and Twitter. How to do, please, Gadia? Let us see. Now, constant. Now we are slowly getting into what is neural network. Neural network will have set of input. That input could be anything. Imagine you are giving image file also. It's a art. Every image is in the form of pixel. So it will have height, weight, depth. So 3 parameter it will have. Next, beyond this height, weight, depth, it will have R, G, B component. That's all. Underneath, every pixel it is possible to decompose into 3 integer values. Ultimately, it is integer value. So these are all going to become your input. I hope so every one of you knows image is a grid of pixels. every pixel is associated with RGB value. Image has height, width and depth. So these are not. This is called bias, we can say bias. What is bias? Again, maybe shortly people may be addressing, other resource persons may be addressing to you. Bias is attached everywhere, every layer, every computation. So very first time, the bias will maybe consider, we can consider as a zero also or one also. The minimal value, zero means it will cancel. Most of the information it will cancel. So that we need to set to one. So the, later on, this will become bias component. These all will be treated as weights. People will call weights. Only to the first layer, they will call it as input layer. Rest all hidden layer, last output layer. It is white or transparent. White box is only input and output. Rest all black box, hidden. We are not sure what exactly it is happening. Nowadays it is possible. Every layer, what is the information feature are extracted or identified, that we can understand. But what exactly happening inside, not able to understand. That is what Saturday you will be having. Very, very, very important and a recent trendy research. It's called explainable AI. After understanding AI, you need to go to AutoML or explainable AI or model compression. These are all the three hot core area of research. So next, it will be converted into weights. Next, it will do the linear operation. What is linear operation? Sum and product. It will do sum and product. X input and weight. Something it will do multiplication. This multiplication plus. Then without multiplication or with the multiplication. X1, X2. Only this kind of operation will happen. X1 into weight, X3 into something. It will multiply. This is called linear. This is our childhood math. Nothing more is new. This operation, very first it will happen. Very next operation, what it will happen is step function. This step function or activation, activation layer or activation, they will call it as activation. Here you need to invest a lot of time in order to understand. I will be addressing minimum 15 minutes this. But you can take it as a core area of this also. Later part, you can publish as a paper, you can try or you can experiment or you can contribute a new activation function. Nowadays, a bundle of 30 plus activation functions, I'm just telling roughly, I'm not sure exactly, 30 plus activation functions have come up to the market. It is in the white paper. We can apply 30 plus activation functions. Then it will give output layer. So this is what completely happening in the mechanism internally. So minimal understanding. There is a bias. Very first layer itself I am talking. This is called input layer. In the input layer, some information will go. Even video, even speech, everything is digital. We are not working on analog signal recent days. So every digitized information will have some numerical value. That's all. That numerical value is called input. Video is what? Collection of frames. I think so. 10 frames, 10 images per frame. I guess something is there. I'm not sure. But the number of images per frame is called video. That's all. In a frame, how many images it captures? See, I'm moving this hand. It becomes video. How it becomes video is, it will start capturing, rapid fast capturing of images happening. So one frame will fit into n images, probably I guess 10, not more than 15, that much I'm sure. So that's all. Finally, it works in the image level. Finally, it works in the pixel level. Although we talk about video, but three-dimensional data, that multi-dimensional data it will become. That is the only difference. Now, finally, we are decomposing what we discussed earlier. See, this is bias. Here, this picture, it is represented clearly. Rest all input. Only for the external world, it is called X or input. The moment it is fed to the machine, it is called weights. Watch carefully. It is called technically weights. Don't get confused. It's a number, that's all. Then first it do summer. It is, they are telling summer or linear action or linear combination, anything you can do. So this is what happening. See, look at, I said now, X into W multiplication plus bias. This is what happening. It is based on number of inputs, number of nodes in a layer. I will show you step by step. We have time till 12:40. By that time, we'll make you to understand. This is called threshold unit or activation unit. All are same. Every node, neural network, we are telling now. What is network? Collection of nodes. Collection of nodes are called layer. This is one layer. I am arranging a layer. Every node has a combination. It has some input. Every node has input. Where it available in the network, we no need to worry. Every node has a input. Every node has a output. Single input or multi output, that part you no need to worry. One output. In between, every node is doing two actions. One is linear action. Another one is threshold unit or activation. Activation. These two things only. Every, that's all neural network. Nothing more to understand in the beginning. This is sufficient. This is called neural network. This node, every node is a matter. Every node carries two different actions. One is linear combination. Another one is, that is weights of connection. See, inputs, bias. Very clearly this image represents. Then threshold. That threshold, it can be any function. Imagine it is a function, f of x. Don't worry anything else. It is a function. The summed information or that linear action is given to one function. That much is sufficient. That knowledge is more than enough. 24 FPS, thank you, because bias is essential. What is bias is perfect learning never it will happen in the machine. So what is the bias? How much it is not learning? How much it is learning? What is the deviation? That is called bias. Initially we are not giving any bias. Very minimal level we are giving one. You can this bias, even STTP1 addressed more than half an hour, bias and variance. You please look at that also if possible. In the same Supraja Madam channel, it is available. Bias. So, bias in learning. What is bias? Is, for example, one easy way I will make you to understand. So, I am teaching you or anyone or your student. 50 minutes I am teaching. That entire 50 minutes could you be able to grasp and can you reproduce immediately? Not possible, no. At least 10% loss of information it will happen, no? What I articulated, you may tend to forget some 10% of information. However, you are genius, definitely you would be forgetting. Not only my teaching, anybody, anyone, even you teach to me, I cannot reproduce it 100%. I may tend to miss some amount of information. Bias will be there in every corner of learning. Nobody can grasp 100%. Even when you read a textbook, forget about my teaching. Even when you read a textbook, can you take simple real-time example? That real-time example only I'm telling, okay. See, image, every pixel is X. That is what weight. You have image, no? Image, what I said, image is a gallery of pixel. What is pixel? It is a RGB value, composition of RGB value. It varies from 0 to 250. This is very basic foundation. All of us know, I hope so. If at all computer science, I don't know about other disciplines. So these 250 are electronics. You guys also has vision. So this is image. See, look at my picture in this web camera. My image is what? Composition of RGB. This every pixel value only constitutes our appearance. So pixel. This pixel, one pixel is x1. Let us take for example, this is 100 value. This 100 is x1. I'm passing my own picture to this neural network, let us imagine. Because 100, this is real, almost this corner of, top left corner of my image is white color, gray color. So the value will become lesser only. So let us say my mic, the blue color, my mic, my headphone, no? My headphone more or less is here. So this may be 200, the pixel. So the next is 200. This is what input. Input is only to the user. For you, the human being, it is called input. The moment this 100, 200 is fed to the node, it is called weight. That's all. No simple example. Imagine you are working on computer vision. NLP, if I take it, it would be a little more tricky to understand. So this is image. My own image, what I am appearing on the screen. This image I am sending, let us imagine. This is a composition of RGB value. My image is composition of several pixels. Every pixel is constituted by RGB value. So this has a numerical representation. Every pixel I need to send to the neural network as an input. My image itself I need to send as an input, no? Then every pixel naturally will become input. That input is x1, x2, x2. That x1, x2, x3 for the human understanding. You and me, we are all human. When the same information or same data or the integer value is passed on to the node, it is called weights. That's all. Don't worry anything more. The moment the weights are subjected to the node, node will carry out two different operations. One is linear combination. Another one is it will do thresholding or it will do activation, some function. Imagine some function that is where research is going on across the world. That how they are using that function only the challenge and research, core research. So that is where, let us imagine a function. For that so many, sigmoid activation function, Tanh function, ReLU function, ELU function, leaky ReLU, so many are available. SoftMAT, so many are available. Let us not to worry. I will touch upon that also. So that function, after subjected to that function, you will get output. In between, ramp function, so many are there. So okay, now this is one node action I'm telling, please understand. This is one node action. Now how the neural network, micro level we are talking. See, neural network, this is called dense neural network. Everything connected with everyone. This picture, input picture, now neural network is made up of, I'm coming to one node, micro level over. Neural network is made up of layers. What is layer? You will ask question. For that also I have picture. Look at. This is what layer. Input layer, hidden layer, output layer. 1 minute. So yeah, this is what. Input layer, hidden layer. Simple neural network I'm telling. So this is input layer, hidden layer. So far now what I was talking about is one circle, one node. Collection of nodes. When it becomes input, this is input layer. This all activity will happen only with the hidden layer. So the moment it comes out of the input and fits to this layer, it is called weights. So here only that linear combination sigma and f of x is happening. So how many layer like this you are going to do? Here, number of node per layer, you and me cannot decide. That is hyperparameter. Anything which cannot be decided prior to the experiment, it is called hyperparameter. Depending upon the context, your data set, your problem statement, the way you train the model only decides. Number of layers, next, node per layer I'm talking. Similarly, how many layer I should have? If you ask question, no answer, no thumb rule. Now, node per layer, number of layers are hyperparameter. So that is where people are doing research. That is where you need to do experiment. You need to come out with your paper, your inferences. Let us go back. This is what layer. This layer, what are all the types of layer will be available? Fully connected layer, convolution layer, deconvolution layer, and recurrent layer. What it is? Nothing to worry. Immediately afternoon, you will be having session CNN. By that time, these all the three layers they will be addressing. You will be having RNN coming week, RNN network. They will be addressing you what exactly. But you should know there are four layers available. That is what right now I'm talking. What is fully connected layer is dense layer. See, the node one from the previous layer, imagine I have two nodes in the first layer. This is layer one I am calling. This is layer two I am calling. Every node information is given to everyone. If I prepare a suite, I will give all to my neighbors. It is like that. Then this node information I'll be giving to all other nodes. This is called fully connected layer. Otherwise, technically, it is called dense layer, dense network. So similarly, next layer is available. Everywhere this should continue. Next question you will ask. It is your choice. Only between these two layers you can design as a fully connected layer. Later on, you can decide in any form. That let us understand slowly. These are all the four layers. So look at what is the meaning of layer is. You are giving this person as an input. This is a classification. It classifies car, person and animal. It detects. If you give, see, first input, you are giving input pixel, see, visible layer. What is the meaning visible? You and me, what I am thinking, I am doing and what we are seeing is visible layer. Visible layer, this all. This is what information, I said na RGB. See, look at this is blue, this is red combination. It is given. First hidden layer, it starts identifying edges. That is the power of very first layer will take minimal information. Next layer, it will take corners and the contours. Contours means boundary. See, if you look at my face, boundary starts, my face is over. How you say your face is good or bad? There is a contour. After that, hair texture, some other things comes into the picture. So that the contour, yeah, the eyes, say contour. This is contour is what? This headphone, contour is, this is the contour. So that identifies. Third, object parts, other object parts. Every layer tries to learn something. Every day if you sit and read deep learning, na, so we can able to understand. Maximum I would have invested 6 months to 8 months of time. I exactly started what is deep learning with the first coding. I remember December 20th. Till then, I don't know anything about deep learning. Last December. Today, I am sitting and addressing. It is possible. What it is happening, even our brain also has a lot of hidden layer, I think so. Every time when we learn, little information is learned and passed on to the next layer, and when it becomes output, when I'm speaking, lot of neural network is learning. Every layer is capturing some information, interconnecting. That interconnection only, everybody learns. The way of articulation varies from one person to another person. Everybody knows the subject. How that varies? The way the neurons interconnects each information, what my neuron already know, what are all the story I know, that story only I will connect and I will talk. That is where everybody's talk is different. Same imagination you apply here as well. So this is a layer. Every layer has several nodes. Several layer constitute an architecture. So that every layer tends to learn something. See, if I sit and open deep learning book today, I will learn little. Then tomorrow, I will learn much more. Third day, I will learn much more. Fourth day, I will start connecting in different perspectives. Fifth day, maybe consistently if I work on something, convolution layer for 45 days to 80 days or 2 years, definitely I can do something breakthrough research. It is possible. How it is happening is the levels of learning happening in every layer. Same here. So how many hidden layer, if you ask anybody questions for this example, how many hidden layers are available? This is output layer classified. This is input layer. You should not talk that. So there are three hidden layers available. See, clearly they have mentioned first hidden layer, second hidden layer, third. This is what your original image. This is user point of view. When this user point of view, how she looks will not be matter for machine. This entire image is converted. into this kind of information. This information only gone. That is why after the translation of this X to before feeding to machine, it is called as weights. I said now, only for you and me it is X. When it goes to node, it is weight. I said now, why? See, it is not going actual information how I appear now. It is going with color information. That's all. Nowadays with the Python code, what is hidden? Hidden layer, that's all. Hidden layer means that is what explainable A. Saturday, one full day, the syllabi is designed for HTTP 4, explainable AI. They will be talking about only this hidden layer, nothing to worry. What is hidden layer is what exactly is happening there. How my picture, my appearance is translated internally. How finally it tells that I belong to a person category. It may put me into animal category also. Who knows? Look at a recent some cricket match, that bald head, coach or comparer, somebody will tell, I don't know cricket, I never watch, I don't know A to Z of cricket. That bald head is treated as a volleyball. Hot news, sensation news is going on. Artificial intelligence, artificial intelligence algorithm started capturing that bald head person, not captured the ball. It seems entire show is making fun. So it is like that. Yeah, football match, okay. Fine. So that football also, I don't know anything. So look at, this is what happening. It will classify. So why it is hidden, it is called is, what exactly happening, that is called, even machine learning is also hidden only. What exactly internally happening, you and me don't know. We internally, externally, we will talk some data point and we will hand calculation, we will explain the math model and articulation and we'll go on. That is why it is called hidden layer. Nowadays, it is not hidden layer. It is explainable. It is possible to understand. Even with Python code, if you use 3 to 4 layer or 5 layers, every 5 layer, it is possible to get answer. You can ask question. Number of layers, more is better, lesser is better. If number of... now only some Pawan is asking question. Yeah, Pawan Kumar. Come on. I said, number of node, number of neuron, you and me cannot decide. That is why research, even useless data, if you work on also, people will appreciate you, consider you to publish at least to Scopus Index, UGC Index journal. Because those are all hyperparameter. You and me cannot say. That is what I said earlier. In a company, neural network, look at here. I'll show. In this picture, this explanation, 3 hidden layer I'm telling now. Simple hidden layer I shown you now. This is input layer, forget output layer, don't talk anything, hidden layer. If you ask question, why you are using 3 neuron? No answer. If you ask question, why not 20 neuron? No answer. Why were you use 10 layer? No answer. It is hyperparameter. Until you get a certain answer, but you need to understand in high pedestrian this deep learning functionalities, then you may able to understand something. I'm not that much level. I can say I'm intermediate level of deep learner. So I'm not expert. So maybe possible. That is very rare. Only 10% of deep learners or specialists knows why it is happening. That is why they are calling it as hidden layer. Number one. Number of nodes per layer, number of layers, you and me cannot decide. That is called hyperparameter. Just for another 10 to 20 minutes, fix the sequence of neurons. Yeah, that is possible. Sequence of neurons is possible. Another 20 minutes. I have only 40 more minutes. Another 20 minutes. Please, no more questions. I'll wrap it first. I have prepared 35 page. I am into right now 10th page. So allow me to proceed with. Now, component of neural network, I'm telling. The very first component is layer. Over. You understood something. That's why you started asking question. So that understanding is sufficient for me. Every layer, what it will have? Neurons. Then within the layer, every node, what it will have? Activation function. Every node, what it will receive? Weight. Every node, what it has? Bias. Sorry, every layer what it has, bias. That's all. These are all the components of neural network. Then based on the type of connectivity, connecting to each other. It is called feed forward back propagation. What is feed forward is, it will keep communicating to the forward layer. What is happening in the output, it doesn't know. What is backward propagation is, people decided the variant, that is where recurrent neural network flavors and its variants have come. It will talk about the output error to the input. This is what your loss function, this is what the error happened. Come on guy, you didn't learn properly this much. That information is given fed back to the, from the beginning, the first layer. That is called back propagation. For example, I'm conducting exam for you. You are writing examination. I'm correcting your paper. I'm just distributing. I don't talk to you anything. If I put 0 also, 100 also, I don't speak to you anything. You can't understand. Rather, if I say this is where you are going wrong, this is where you are doing very good, that is why I reduced the mark. You need to improve this particular portion. That is where pedagogy, every teacher need to give feed closure and reflection to our students. Choose childhood days, school days people do, but college we don't do. We call roll number one, come, take your paper, that much only we do. Closure and reflection makes people to learn better. Understand why they are right and where they are wrong. That is where called it is back propagation. That's all. First method, what I'll do? I'll conduct the exam to you. You will sit and write, and finally I'll just throw the paper. I just give the paper or throw the paper. That is feed forward. Rather, second one, what I'm doing, I'll do two steps. I'll make you to realize where you are right, where you are wrong. I will make you to give the recommendation how to improve also. I will give you a clue. I'll give you a material, at least a page number, where to go and study. Or the website URL where you should study for that particular concept. Or I may teach you something. That is called back propagation here. Nothing more. Next, error function. Error function I'll be addressing today, detail. I don't know, only 20, 30 more. Hyperparameter tuning. So what is hyperparameter? You all asked the question, how many neuron, how many layers, that all hyperparameter. I have detailed notes for hyperparameter as well. So for further learning, if you are interested to learn further about this, you can refer this link. It is much more, see, yeah, grammatical mistake, I'm correcting. You can do this now. What are all hyperparameter? Here I said hyperparameter is also part of neural network architecture. Error function is also part of neural network architecture. Types of neural network architecture: feed forward, back propagation, depending upon the connectivity. Bias is always available with every layer, every iteration, every epoch. Epoch is called iteration. First step to last step doing is epoch. Then weights. All our input initially weights. Later on, okay, you are agreeing for extra time. Thank you, Manish Kumar. Okay, what is bias and weights? Now only you get started. Okay, as I literally explained bias with the example, every part of learning, some bias will happen. For example, if I teach you for 1 hour, you can't reproduce it exactly. Madhumitra, you can't exactly reproduce. You will miss something. Human brain also tend to do like that. How the machine imitated brain called neural architecture will learn exactly. There would be some bias. Definitely will be bias. Not only my teaching. I give you 20 pages of paper. You need to sit and study for half an hour or 1 hour. Can you reproduce it as a, exactly that 100% without missing any concept? Not possible. That is where bias comes into the picture. Much more. The STDP-1 bias I addressed for half an hour. You please watch that video, STDP-1. Maybe end of the STDP-1 something. Weights. Initially, the pixels are weights. That pixel, whatever we see, that is fed, our image, our face, our image, this appearance is fed as an input to the computer vision neural network architecture. The moment my pixel values face is fed to the neural network, it is called weight. Only for you it is X input. So see, never I have written input. I started net to neural network is made up of neuron, made up of weights. Probably I can write like this, order is changed. this is not right. After this weights and bias only, I should not even hear. After that, model of network. After this only, I need to write activation function. After how it is connected is important. Then activation function, error function, hyperparameter. This is appropriate order of the way of architecture. Nothing to worry. Whatever you have doubt within this week, you will get clarified, because everyone will tend to address about this all. I'm just giving you holistic picture. They will go detail for their own architecture, what the resource person is addressing. Come here, hyperparameter, dimensionality of the data, patch size, stride. Patch size, stride, afternoon they will be addressing you much more better way. See, this is image. You have a filter. Filter can be 1x1 filter or 3x3 filter, anything. Don't ask that question. So this filter I need to go for convolving. Convolving means I need to work on image with this filter. I need to make marriage between these two guys. That's all. Interaction. Image and the filter need to interact each other. That is called convolution. So this convolution, they just a dot product, a matrix multiplication you call, no, that's all, nothing more you need to worry. Matrix operation. This is one matrix, smaller matrix. Image is a larger matrix. You need to go for that. So that is patch size. Stride. Stride is how much? 3x3, 1x1, 2x2. This is what stride. These two together goes. Then it will work on this and this. Then it will move. This sliding, this window sliding is happening. What is padding? See, image size is different. This size is different. Then it will move here. Fine. See, here 2x2 pixel is available. One more 1x1 is missing. For that, I need to patch with padding. This padding can be patched with 0 or you can patch with 1. Again, this is hyperparameter. You need to decide what kind of padding you should do. Lot of things. Learning is easy. While working, it is hyperparameter. Number of feature maps to generate. How many features you want to extract. So depending upon that, you need to use number of layers. Activation function. Bundle. 30 plus activation function. Someone said ramp also. So those all activation function. Which one you need to use? That is also hyperparameter. Then dropout layer. What is dropout layer is, look at, already I said, several neurons, several layers, densely connected, densely, highly connected. So this much connection, what will happen is, it will take overfitting. What is overfitting? Exact learning will happen. Overfitting is a danger for testing time, for reliability of the answer, for deploying into the business use case. So what they will do is, they will disconnect that connectivity. That is called dropout. Please understand. Say I am connecting. See, imagine this link is one. So many link, na? Number all the links, all the edges. Maybe here itself 50 edges would have come. How many? 4 into 4 combination, 16 edges. 15 I said, some 16 edges. Imagine 16 edges. So what is dropout is, they, you should know how to identify overfitting also. That is, tomorrow morning they will be addressing optimization technique. By the time they will address in detail. So dropout, randomly only you need to drop out. You need to disconnect this some layer. I want to disconnect this fellow, this fellow, this fellow. That you can't control. Random nature, but you can drop out. What is dropout? Dropout student, Alibaba dropout student, they are calling now. Many dropout students are big entrepreneurs now today, legends of business now. So that dropout is what? Withdrawal. In between they are coming out. That's all. The same dropout only, here also meaning. Okay, now let us move on. So look at dropout network. Yeah, luckily I have brought no drop network, fully connected. Look at, no disconnect. Next, dropout network. This link is disconnected. This is dropout. Drop connect network. Whatever dropped out, something goes wrong, no, they will connect it back. this is what kind of breakthrough researchers, people have done it already. So this no dropout you can do with your research, dropout or no dropout, both are okay. No dropout, see, so many they dropped out. One level of dropped out information they are retaining back, that is drop connect. Next, pooling layer, aggregation. So before this active output layer, anywhere you can use, normally before this output layer they will use pooling layer. That pooling layer is called max average sum. This also CNN time they will be detailed, they will be addressing. I just give you the overview picture. Max pooling layer, average pooling layer, sum pooling layer. Pooling layer also working with different functions. So there are three functions I'm bringing here. Now layers. First you need to decide layers. Within the layer nodes, I want to show you one playground, that is TensorFlow playground. Famous, any AI trainer will show that. Training phase, only adjacent layer can get connected. Imagine, next question nobody asked, luckily. Layer 1 and layer 3, I want to connect to each other. Not possible. Adjacent layers only can get connected. Now, every, oh my God, this, can you able to see W to the power K IJ, that's all. This is called weight. What is weight, you ask? Now the mathematical definition. I, neuron number in the present layer, neuron number in the adjacent layer number. How the weights are passed, it has reference, because it is not working in this edge pattern, weight pattern. So this weight should have identity. Every weight is represented with the previous layer number, adjacent layer number, and from which layer it is given. So this all information together, it is called weight. That's all. Input, normally input would become text, image, audio, video. Hidden layer is related to math. Now you ask a question, now what is hidden layer? Math is hidden layer. What math? You and me cannot decide. Every research paper, every person, they will be working on minister data itself. You can find 1,000+ papers. Why 1,000+ paper? The way they are hyperparameter tuning and building the architecture, predicting the output and loss function varies. No map. Each layer will try to focus on feature extraction. What is the role of hidden layer? Each layer will focus on feature extraction, like color extraction, edge extraction, vertical line, horizontal line, size, alignment, geometrical information, orientation, etc., etc. These are all the information extracted by the hidden layer, feature extraction. The initial itself, I shown the picture. One lady picture, every layer, what are all the information it captures. Every node in the hidden layer will perform two tasks. Integration or summation or linear action, I said. Activation, this or threshold. Every level will have a bias value. Every level, every layer will have a bias value. What is bias? It is worth investing. I tell you, don't ask question to any resource person. You ask also, they will tell one line answer. For your clear crystal understanding, invest half an hour. Google Mata is there. Google Mata has YouTube, audio, video, all. Please invest your time and understand about bias until you personally convince. Your personal convincing is matter. Now, initial hidden layer will normally, the first layer will capture low level features. Next set of hidden layer will capture middle level features. Final set of hidden layer will capture high level features. This is the usual way will happen internally. There is no thumb rule for the number of nodes per layer. Your question answer I made already. And the number of layers as of now, it depends on the data set and the problem statement. Fully connected network or dense layer, when each node is connected with all the nodes of adjacent layer, this fully connected layer, I said. Next, each layer can have different activation function. One is change integration function, multi-layered perceptron, quadratic function, spherical function. So this is called activation function. Now slowly we touch upon activation function. I don't know, 35 pages I may not able to cover. Output would be vector of numbers finally. At last, finding the correct weight after multiple iteration of training is possible. Multiple iteration, otherwise called epochs. Multiple iteration with that. Now quickly, and we have only 10 more minutes. activation function also I may not be able to touch upon, I guess. So much information I have brought in, but no time, even hands-on not possible. Yeah, directly we can go ahead. See, lot of stuff I have brought. This is one of the activation function. Look at this. This is not zero-rooted. Zero-rooted activation function is Stanwich. This is 0.5-rooted. So this is sigmoid function. So this sigmoid function, whatever the input we are giving, it will convert into probabilistic values between 0 to 1. Probabilistic representation. So a lot of math involved in deep learning, maybe 4-5 hours more than sufficient to understand. Now look at Tanach function. When we go to Tanach function, look at Tanach function. That is where the variant of sigmoid only Tanach function. People invented, initially they have invented a sigmoid curve, sigmoid activation function. Later on they invented Tanach function. It will feel like dizzy initially, don't worry. Later on you will be able to understand after a 1 week. If not, the subsequent sessions, whatever is possible, I will address. Because this material will be with you, go through it, then we can quickly discuss. Now, what are all the types of loss functions? With that, one more animation I will complete. Your output variable is meant for predicting numerical value, that is called continuous variable. If the output variable is meant for predicting categorical classification or that kind of model, only two types. So let us see first one. Imagine this is the month salary, first month salary, 6 months, month sale report. Actual sale is this. My machine predicted sale is this. Time series analysis with the LSTM you can do. Error. The discrepancy between these two is error. What is the meaning is, I'm writing exam, gate examination. You know about my number of study hours, my knowledge pattern. You will be telling you will get only this much mark, you are telling. Actual results comes, there will be difference, no? The way you predicted about me and the actual mark, there will be positive difference or negative difference. That difference is called error. Okay. This error, mean error. This is the mean. Just what you should do, the formula, look at sum of effort. This Excel sheet also, if you want, I will give. Mean absolute error. Mean squared error. This I thought of walking down very detailed. These are all the types of error functions available. While writing a paper, you can do these all also. Then mean square, root mean squared error, mean squared error, formula, everything is available. Mean percentage error, not influenced by you. Mean absolute error, Huber loss, combination of both. These are all the error function. I know there may be many more. So look at, among these all, the best method is mean absolute percentage method. This I haven't calculated. I have brought the material for this, and this Huber loss, it uses both the MSC, MAE. What is MSC is mean squared error. What is MAE is mean absolute error. Now let us understand what is the advantage, disadvantage of each. Mean error does not capture the underlying data. If you have plus and minus, look at it will cancel. See, minus 10. Plus 50, minus 50. It both will get cancelled each other while doing summation. Then this minus 10, minus 60, it will cancel 70. Minus 30, it will cancel this. Then what I will get? Nothing you will get. Then that will lead to mislead our prediction. Next, mean absolute error. We cannot perform derivatives or calculus because of absolute values. It is not possible for doing derivatives. Deep learning, full of derivatives, we should be thorough. Derivatives and matrix algebra, probability, nothing more than matrix. That also, and not only for you study material 499 something, I will send to Suprajan Madam coordinator, she will forward. I have lot of stuff. I'll be coming 3 days, every day I'll be coming out with a lot of material. That itself will take for you to 1 month to sit and study. Don't worry. Next, we cannot perform derivatives and calculus. Mean squared error. Units are getting varied due to square of errors. Square, when you do know the meaning, what is that minus 10? 10 rupees loss in that month. Plus 50, I got profit 50. That is dollar value or currency value, let us imagine. So units are getting varied. When I am squaring, it will be misleading my interpretation. Next, root mean square, it gets influenced by units. Interpretation will vary from context to context. The same error value, Indian will speak in terms of rupees. The same error value, Americans will talk in terms of dollar. So interpretation problem. Next, mean percentage error. Both this all formula also I had given in the word file. Both positive and negative will get cancelled. Mean absolute percentage error, quite good. It's much better. No disadvantage, quite good. That is why nothing I have written. There I have written. These are all the disadvantages. This we need to address minimum 10 minutes for better understanding, but no time. Now discrete variable. If it is discrete prediction, that is classification, car, person, this kind of animal, that prediction is called a classification. Here, most of the time they use as probability. For that, information theory, this is called a concept behind this one. Information theory is what? I'll make you to understand quickly. Purity, impurity, that two word you should understand thoroughly. That is more than enough. For example, sun rises in the east. What information you will have? It is fixed. You and me cannot change. Thousands and thousands of years, sun rises in the east direction only. In this, information content is poor. No information. For example, all among Indian women, who is doing the best artificial, means AI specialist award also giving. Women AI specialists they are giving. Women in data science forum going in big way across the globe. So I'm not into that forum yet. Maybe I'm thinking to join or not to join. Why to go to women identity? I don't like that concept. So that the information content, then information is too much. Among Indian women, who is best in artificial intelligence is the question I'm asking. Here, purity is more. The first one, impurity, because no information available. Here, choices are available. The best artificial percentage of the best AI specialist among women, let me ask question. Maybe 10%. 10% possible. Let us imagine 280 women scientists or artificial intelligence specialist divided by perhaps let us imagine 1 lakh artificial intelligence experts may be available in India. So this has lot of information. I need to do infer information out of it. 1,000 ladies, 1,000 women knows artificial intelligence in this country. Then I need to identify the best top 10 people or top 3 people. So this has information content more. This has purity, more purity. Vice versa, you should understand. Sun rises in the east. Easy to understand, remember for the LKG kid. But no information, that is fixed phenomena, constant. Whereas here you have more. This is called purity. Sun rises in the east. Imagine that is equivalent example for impurity. Equity. When your data is more impure, when fiction, that is where. See, very when information content is very high, then the probability would be very low. Information content is very high because 1 lakh women scientists are available. Then expertise people may be 10% available. That is what. Now here, what are all those things? Binary classification, loss function, entropy technique, impurity measure. This also addressed in the second STTP. Detailed, maybe half an hour I addressed about entropy, binary cross entropy. This is with all the category, car, horse, or dog, cat, and lion, person. These combination I want to classify. And by the time, comparing with all other classes, I need to calculate entropy. That's all clue. Binary class entropy, Hing loss, multi-class classification loss functions. One is multi-class cross entropy. Pullback, this they will call KL, even I don't know to produce KL divergence loss, then confusion. These are all the last functions available. Now quickly we go to one of the discussion. I will pass on these two excels if you wish. TensorFlow AI playground, that's all. So click this. This is excellent playground to learn all of us. So the data, only four data they have brought. One is two class. Next is non-linear data. Next is multi-class data. Complex non-linear classification. Look at the data distribution. How complex, spiral pattern. So although this is non-linear, it is easier. The boundary line I can draw here, the function, it is easier to give the boundary for the classification. Now it is very tough. Now you can play with this playground for your best understanding. Look at ratio of training to test data. How much ratio training data, test data? 60%, 70%, that is split person. Then noise, whether you want to work with noise, without noise, outlier. Look at, see, after noise, lot of blue color is coming to the boundary of that. So with the noise, without noise, you can adjust. Batch size, one batch, 10 batch, how many batch? Batch normalization, the technique, types of normalization techniques also we need to address for 1 hour. So that is batch normalization technique. See, features, number of input features, how many you want, you can decide. See, these are all X1, X2, quadratic feature, quadratic, then X1, X2, sine X feature. What are all the features you want? You can decide. Neurons per node. Look at, if I click plus, it will increase a neuron. If I click minus, it will decrease a neuron. Number of layer, I can add one more layer with two neurons. So two neurons in the output. Okay, two class classification. So first let me choose this. So noise 25 noise, now 15 noise, 15% it is given. Now learning rate, this is another hyperparameter. Learning rate should not become too smaller, it will take lot of time for the epochs duration time. Learning rate should not be too larger. So the ideal learning is 0.01 or 0.003 or 0.01. These three are ideal rate. Say activation function, which one? Sigmoid, linear activation, Tanach activation, ReLU activation. So I'm using sigmoid. Regularization technique, this also addressed in the previous STTP. L1 regularization, ridge regularization, lasso regularization, or shortly L1, L2 they will call. Which regularization? Regularization rate also you can fix. So these are all the hyperparameter. Next, problem type classification or regression, last one. Let it be classification. Now, see, click this button, it will train. Look at test loss, train loss. No overfit, no underfit, exact fit. 0.5, 0.5. It classifies. So test data. See, test data, it classifies clearly. Discretize output. So this is what? Minus 1, 0, 1. So this is what? The playground. You can try with the difference. See, I'm going for Tanach. Tanach play. See, Tanach, it gives a boundary. Look at the boundary. Orange color, blue color boundaries. So this is the way you can learn this. Just I'll show, send this link. I don't know. The original link, I don't know. After search only I got now. You will also have this. 1 minute. Yeah, this is the playground list. This is the playground URL. It is available in my notebook. See, look at. These are all the loss function formula. There I have shown you the calculated Hans simulation value. Next, loss function. To read more about loss function, you can use. Similarly, this is the loss function calculation for classification. Deep learning challenges. What are all the deep learning challenges? Gradient function, overfitting, and gradient vanishing, and gradient exploding, activation function choosing, error function, vanishing gradient, exploding gradient, error surface challenges, learning rate challenges, decay parameter, gradient descent, one more is gradient ascent, momentum, then optimizer. Famous optimizer is Adam optimizer. Choosing an optimizer, these all are the challenges. Not only these, many more challenges. How to avoid overfit? How to fix the dropouts? Minimize overfit. Initial dropout, drop connect, noise. How to types of noise? How to deal? There are three types of noise: gradient noise. I have put a few noises. Data manipulation technique. Data augmentation. If the data is not sufficient, we need to augment data. What is the meaning of augment data? Is rotation. This is the picture I'm giving. You can rotate like this, 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 then scale and coloring and white image. My own image, you can convert it into black and white or grayscale or all other combinations of coloring effect you can give. That is how you can give a data augmentation if it is not available. Parameter choices. So what are all the parameters you can choose? That are all the parameters we discussed earlier. Weight initialization, types of weight initialization available. Initial weight, how to choose the filter, how many types of filters available. How initially weight we need to give. I said a 3x3 window, no? Stride, that weight initialization, how to do that weight initialization also, we have lot of technique. So these are all the optimizers one should be thorough when we step into deep learning. So next, coming to here, very first, okay, what to speak, what not to speak, I don't know. Now deep learning, applications of machine learning, neural network cells, activation functions also. This is the playground, neural network playground. There are few stuff I want to, TensorFlow, one coding I wanted to show, that also not possible. Okay, these are all, first we should understand TensorFlow. The best way to work is PyTorch, then TensorFlow, Keras, Theano, and Coffee, so many are available. Among OpenCV, among so many, PyTorch is the best way to work. That is based on the literature, based on invested more than 2 hours to understand the difference, Keras, Theano, TensorFlow, PyTorch. So this PyTorch is the best way to work. See, TensorFlow, Keras, PyTorch, what is the difference? Difficult to program but faster, because TensorFlow initially meant for large data collection, very first competition, that is called ImageNet competition. For 1 lakh images, 1,000 types of labeling. Earlier, people were doing manual labeling. Lotus, peacock, butterfly. These all people labeled in the Google image searches there. Now, people labeled manually. Later on, they thought of why to go for manual. They appointed. After that, they went on with coding methodology. Through that, they launched the competition. Many have taken part, AlexNet, ImageNet, so many pre-trained models. 1 lakh image, 1,000 classes they have predicted. They, in the later year, that competition was open for many years. I don't know, still it is open or not. So the breakthrough, whenever happens, they will be the leading competitor. So that for that, it is brought TensorFlow. Keras, easy to program, bit slower. Python, easy to program, faster. So we may need to adapt PyTorch. The research study shows also all the researcher uses PyTorch than all other libraries and packages. You want that? Yeah, that's all. So with that note, let me conclude for today's session, because I have invigilation right now. So with that, I may not able to proceed further. Thank you all. I'll be meeting you again on Monday. Meanwhile, you will be undergoing much more detailed way of every network flavor. The holistic picture is brought, that's all. The basic understanding, but I couldn't touch upon the coding part. That's all. Something is given to you, that's all. So here I have listed out, see, types of networks, all the types of networks, how the types of networks exist is depending upon the connectivity, how it is connected adjacently to each other layer only. They coined all the types of a complete chart of neural networks is available. It will give you a way to learn, that's all. I'm not giving you full, I'm giving you a road, path, that's all. Then supervised, unsupervised, shallow and deep. These are all the four category of deep learning. The next is, I have classified into supervised, unsupervised, time series, when to use which kind of neural network. I had given you, invested a lot of time for understanding this and brought. So see, parameterized, ReLU, rectifier, soft plus, these are all the activation functions. All the activation functions I have brought in here. Data set, normally training data set, cross validation, development set also they will call, don't worry, that development set is cross validation. In the previous sessions I have addressed about cross validation theory also, practical also, then test set, that's all. So almost roughly I covered right now. So with that note, let me conclude. Thank you all, see you again on now. Yes, ma'am.
For your wonderful session, it's a great insight for all the participants. So they will be eagerly waiting for you for next Monday.
Yeah.
Thank you, participants. And attendance link has been shared, so please fill it. So attendance and feedback, it falls in one form only, so please don't ask separate forms. Shaz, the session 2 will be starting afternoon sharp by 2 o'clock, so be here by 2 yeah. o'clock.
Sujata ma'am, evening I'll be sharing to Supraja madam. Sharply by 5 o'clock I'll be dispatching to Supraja madam. You catch hold of her, I will send you. Okay.
Definitely. Yeah. I will share to you in the WhatsApp group, yeah. So you can get your materials. Thank you.
Yeah, introduction to TensorFlow notebook also I'm having. That notebook I will send you. Then basic level sure. You should understand. Then that 2 Excel sheet I will send you and this Word file I will send you. Then there are so many stuff. Every other session I need to maintain some excitement, no? So I will share with you later. See you all. Bye.
Thank you, everyone. We will meet after the lunch, sharp by 2 o'clock. Thank you so much. Bye. Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.